At the Maasvlakte, we invest in sustainable and efficient rail development. Imports and exports of goods in Europe and in the Netherlands have increased enormously in recent decades. Reliable, efficient, and easily accessible rail connections generate a competitive edge for the Netherlands. That's why the Port Authority, the Ministry of Infrastructure and Water Management, and the European Union invest in infrastructure to facilitate this growth. 75% of Dutch rail freight passes through the Port of Rotterdam. At present, terminal capacity on the Maasvlakte is undergoing a major expansion. An important prerequisite for growth is the good competitive position of seaports. To be prepared for further volume growth in rail freight, the Port Authority and ProRail have developed a logistical vision for the port area. It describes the capacity bottlenecks in the port area that need to be tackled. We resolve these bottlenecks by investing in optimization of processes and expansion of infrastructure. On the Maasvlakte, we are investing in sustainable and efficient rail development. That development will be organized in different phases, and it will consist of the construction of a new rail yard, Maasvlakte-Zuid, the electrification of the district park triangle and the outer contour, and the capacity enhancement of the C2 bend. The Maasvlakte-Zuid rail yard will increase the rail capacity of rail yards on the Maasvlakte. Ultimately, the new yard will consist of 24 tracks in 4 bundles that can accommodate freight trains of 740 meters long and 2 drive-through tracks. To optimize the logistical process and make it more sustainable, we are electrifying the last sections of the port railway line at the Maasvlakte. To reach the final destination at the port, trains now have to switch to a diesel locomotive. That leads to longer waiting times. We are electrifying the district park triangle and the outer contour so that diesel locomotives will no longer be needed. The result will be lower emissions, fewer stops, shorter waiting times, and lower costs. At present, rail traffic still intersects at the C2 bend. That costs time because trains have to wait before they can proceed to the terminals. The capacity enhancement at the C2 bend will separate the flows of rail traffic so that substantially more freight trains can pass the bend daily. The Port Authority will be building the first bundle in the yard through to the end of 2027. To make this development possible, the underground infrastructure will be modified at the following locations. ProRail and the Port Authority are committed to robust rail connections with the hinterland. With all these investments, we are improving international rail freight transport and reducing road transport, and we will have a good alternative for inland navigation when water levels are low or high. This means we're making an important contribution to implementing the climate agreement and the European Green Deal, and we're working together on good accessibility for the Netherlands and the European hinterland.